Hello to everyone, this is the first developer blog video for making a virtual character inside the Motion Builder. And this time I would like to talk about the blend shapes and normals. So by default in Motion Builder there is no computation for normals for the blend shapes and no computation for blend in these normals. Let me show the problem as it is. So I've prepared in Maya two spheres. One I just sculpted and push down a little bit the top part. Another one is just the original sphere with the applied next sphere to it as the blend shape. So what we have, if we have a look at it from the top view, we see that there is no really normals interpolation, just a position, and it looks a little bit ugly. And if, for example, in my case, I'm talking about the virtual character and modern-looking virtual character, that will kill all the idea inside the Motion Builder. There is a possibility, configuration file, we have an option. It's in display group. There are parameters shape blend normals and shape compute normals. By default, they are no. That means there is no computation, so we can activate it. But for me, as I will use the scan model, very tessellated, it will be kind of 500,000 vertices. There is no way to use this option because if I'm talking about the real time, I need to have as close as possible to 60 frames per second. So in my case, when I activate this feature in my high density model, I have kind of 10 frames per second, which is no way to continue that with this option. So what I have made for that is a special solver. So let me show how it works. So this solver works on the GPU, on the compute shader. It's very fast and it probably, there is no big impact on performance when running this solver. And if I open the test, so we see that it's compute the normals the same way we have on our blend shape. So if we now change the weight of our blend shape, we see that the normals very well interpolated according to our weight. So this is what I need for starting working on the virtual character inside the Motion Builder. So on this simple scene, there is no really big difference at how fast and how well this solver compute the normals, because it's not very density mesh. So let me open the face that I will use. It's a scanned model and I will use that face in my for my virtual character, I think. So I go to default render, go to simple view. So this is the quite well density mesh. If we select it and go to properties, we see that it's around 400,000 vertices and 1,600,000 polygons, around that. So this is very density, but I have quite a good performance here, around 60. And so I've prepared the relation constraint to control the blend shape. This is very draft blend shape to activate expression of closed eyes. Very draft because you can see there is a lot of ugly things there that I've made very very fast version in ZBrush. But anyway, the main idea is that by default there is no interpolation for blend for normals during activation our blend shape, so it looks very ugly. And yes, sure, we go to our solver and activate it. So now we see that it looks much better when we activate it, and we also can make zones of blend shapes and paint here details, make a little bit cleaner our blend shape, and it will look perfect. That's what I need for running the virtual character face expressions. Another thing that I also use here that I would like to share, so there is no complex shader activated, but there is some technique which I'm using as the default option that available in MotionBuilder. I'm using layer texture. There are two layers, one for natural face, one for closed eyes. And with the relation constraint, I'm not only activate geometry Blendshape, but I'm controlling the transparency of the layer for my layer texture for the diffuse. So that means when I activate the weight, I'm also changing the texture to fill details for my shape. That's quite important, because sometimes there could be more wrinkles, more other details that need to be visible during the activation of that shape. I have also a solution to make, there is a special dynamic masks. This is a very big tool and complex tool to make masks on the UV map for my head to localize the expression activation, but I will maybe cover that in another video. Anyway, that's what I was thinking to talk about during that video. It's the problem, the first problem that we have in MotionBuilder. It's Blendshape normals. Thanks for watching. Hope you like this series, and see you next video. Bye.